and welcome to the National Indoor Arena and to the 1993 Grand Final of Gladiators. Over the past 14 weeks, we've been watching some 33 contenders battle fiercely for a place in tonight's prestigious final. And now we're down to the elite. Two men and two women are about to face the most exciting hour of their life.
And after tonight's show, two of our contenders will have battled their way through to the big prize of £5,000. Plus, a trip to Hollywood to compete against the American Gladiators. Hooga!
And then, of course, it's off to Barbados for that holiday of a lifetime with their partner. So let's meet our female finalists. They are Georgina Berger
and Jean Klink.
A little bit of support for you tonight, Georgina. Nice to see you looking so relaxed.
Yeah, I don't feel too bad.
Now, I know you've been competing, particularly in swimming, on a national level for quite a few years. How does that compare to coming on Gladiators?
Well, obviously, competing in swimming in quite a few sports obviously helps to get used to a bit of the competition here.
But, and what about the pressure? What's that like? I mean, how are you under pressure?
I don't mind. I'm quite used to competition, and I like if it's fierce, and I like that, but you're never quite used to the pressure under these circumstances, I don't think.
Now, we were chatting backstage, and there's no denying that fitness and stamina certainly comes into taking part in Gladiators, but there is just that element of luck as well, isn't there?
Yeah, that's right. You think everything's going well and anything can happen, so it's just fingers crossed to give it all you got, really.
Well, I hope Lady Luck's smiling on you tonight. We'll see you later. Georgina Berger!
Okay, Jean. Now, remind us again, you've got a pretty unusual job. Tell us, what do you do?
Yeah, I'm an HGV 1 truck driver for Tesco Distribution in Hinckley.
And has that helped you in any events at all?
I think so. It helps build my strength because I have to unload and reload, so it's quite strenuous work.
Now, you've got a little son. Is he here today?
Yeah, Joseph. He's over there with his dad, his grandma and granddad.
All your fans and supporters?
Yeah.
Tell us, now you're getting closer and closer to that final step. What are you going to do if you win the big prize of £5,000?
I think I'll take Joseph to Disneyland.
Oh, well, there you are. Well, best of luck. Off you go, Jean. So, while they're going off to get on their protective equipment, let's introduce you to the two gladiators who are going to be chasing them. They are Zodiac and Falcon.
For their game, why don't we meet the guys, our male finalists tonight. They are Brian Ward
and Phil Norman. Come on, guys.
Hi, Brian. Now, we were talking a little bit before about your work in the RAF. Quite a high-pressured job. One could almost say it's life and death.
Well, there's no lay-bys in the sky, let's put it that way. You can't pull over and lift the bonnet, you just gotta... It's got to rely on the ground crew to get you going.
So how can the experience from that high-pressure job come in sort of useful for gladiators? Because obviously there's tremendous pressure on tonight.
Just going to enjoy myself tonight. It's great.
Have you thought anything at all about what you might do with the money?
My wife's having the money. I don't want it. I'd just like to win tonight. She can have the money.
Well, I hope she took note of that, and I hope that she gets it. Thank Brian Ward, see you later.
Well, Phil, you look very confident. You look very relaxed. How do you really feel inside?
I'm fine. Yeah, I'm fine.
No nerves?
No, none at all. No.
Well, it's early days yet. Tell me, Phil, the last show, you picked up a couple of knocks and bumps. Tell me, what were they first and how are they?
Well, I'm not going to tell you what they are, in case the gladiators hear them. But, I was walking around like Frankenstein for a few days, really stiff afterwards, and got a few bumps, yeah.
But they're okay now?
Yep, they're fine.
Confident tonight?
I'm confident we're going to put in a good show today, yeah. Definitely.
Got to enjoy it, the most important thing.
Definitely, that's without a doubt.
Okay, Phil, off we go. Best of luck.
And the gladiators, they're going to be facing our Cobra and Wolf. After all that chat, the ladies should be ready for their first game, so here's John Sachs.
Thank you, Ulrika, and let me assure everybody at home, that's not me. My ears are much bigger. Event one is Skytrack. Jean in yellow is hooked up and ready to roll. Georgina in the pink. And they'll be chased by Zodiac and Falcon. Thumbs up there from Zodiac. And Falcon keeps her eyes on the road. Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready! Three, two, one! And they're away. Jean, our heavy goods lorry driver, used to hogging the road. Last time out, she scored a maximum 10 points. And Georgina on her last outing was caught. Being chased by these gladiators is enough to send anyone round the bend. And this track has as many corners as the Indy 500. Zodiac waiting to the very last bend. Yes, she makes the sparks fly on Georgina. And Jean clears the line. 10 points. Great start. In the replay, we see how Georgina gave Zodiac a great run for her money, but got caught just before the checkered flag. Scores after the first event, Jean 10, Georgina still to get off the mark. On to the men's. And it's Phil, our martial arts expert, in blue. And Brian, our RAF engineer, in the red. It'll be Wolf after Phil, and Cobra chases Brian. Contenders, ready! Flying start. The martial arts expert kicks it into gear. Phil's previously clocked up 2 wins and a 2nd place, and Brian just the win, but they're certainly getting away from the gladiators. And Cobra and Wolf must feel like a couple of milk floats chasing down some Ferraris up there. And Phil takes the checkered flag, swiftly followed by Brian, and the gladiators left in the car park. Scores after one event, Phil 10, Brian 5. Event 2 is Powerball. And Georgina will be slam dunking the red balls. And Jean's got the blues.
Standing ready on the Powerball pitch, it's Jean and Georgina. But protecting those baskets are Scorpio, Panther and Nightshade.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready!
Hubble, bubble, these three look like trouble.
Three, two, one!
Let's play ball, and Jean powers past Panther. 2 points there, Scorpio sends Georgina flying. Georgina's debut in this. Ow, what a great tackle from Nightshade on Jean. There's Georgina. Yes, 2 points. Right under Nightshade's nose. And look at that. Some great docking and diving up the top there. It's 3 points in the middle from Jean. Again, under the gladiator's nose. Jean, a good track record in this event. That ball's out of play. Previously an 8 and a 4. Oh, good tackle from Panther. What was that? Jean. She gets it in, 2 points. And look at that, something's come out. Better put that away. Oh, good tackle. And Jean, the modesty covered up, taken down. And Georgina, double team there. Jean, is there a way? No, tremendous. And it has to be said, that was one of the most exciting Powerballs we've ever seen. Everyone giving 100%. And in the replay, we see Georgina double-teamed by Panther and Nightshade.
Well, Georgina, I know this is the first time you had a go at Powerball. How did you find it?
Not too bad. Find it a bit hard to get into. First time, not quite aware of, you know, whereabouts to run and things, but it's OK.
It's very fast. Quite a few nasty tackles as well.
Yeah, it's what it's all about. It's a good game.
Well, you picked up 2 points. Now, Jean, you've got quite a good record as far as Powerball goes. Will you be pleased with 7 points?
Yes! Brilliant! Oh, great.
Anything to add?
No, I just like that game very much. I was lucky to get one in the middle this time. I think that helped.
Well done. Let's hear it for Jean and Georgina. And let's hear it for Panther, Scorpio and Nightshade.
Scores after two events, Georgina 2, Jean 17. And there's Brian with the red balls. And Phil's got blue balls.
They're going to be facing the dream team, Warrior, Trojan and Shadow.
Never mind the dream team, this is the mean team. We're talking 60 stones of hostile traffic, all
three,
going in the wrong direction.
2, 1.
Let's play ball. And Phil brought down to earth by Shadow. Oh, out of the frying pan into the fire. Phil flattened by 21 stones of Warrior. There's Shadow doing a demolishing job on Brian. You do feel sorry for these guys. Such weight, but look at that. Slips past the Shadow. You've got to be fast. 2 points there. A convincing takedown by the big fella. What can Brian pull out of the hat here? Lots of dancing, but not... Oh, trips over Phil. Shadow brings him down. Too much hesitation there by Brian. Lovely tango, though. There's Phil, flattened. Brian for 2 points. That came out of nowhere. And Shadow again gets his man, the big fella. Takes some shirt. Phil taken down by Trojan. Well, time up. We've seen just how physical it gets down there, but always played with great spirit and great sportsmanship. In basketball terms, taking on these gladiators must be like trying to get past Orlando Magic's Shaq O'Neal. Look at this replay. You need to come up with something special, and Phil does it, outstretching him.
Phil, an exciting game. I always enjoy watching you. You're quite speedy.
Yeah, but not tonight. No, they stuffed me tonight.
And what about you, Brian? If you turn you around and see, there's a few marks on his back there. Half of your clothes are gone.
A little bit drafty out the back there, yeah.
Anyway, good news. You both scored 2 points. Let's hear it for Brian and Phil. Let's hear it for our gladiators.
Great job by the big fellas. Scores after two events, Brian 7, Phil 12.
And up on her platform, waiting to walk the suspension bridge, is Georgina!
Well, in her heat, she picked up a full 10 by knocking the gladiator off.
And she's going to be against our gladiator's own mean machine, the deadly Nightshade!
And Nightshade's track record speaks for itself.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready! Gladiator!
Georgina takes a run at it. Nightshade. Oh, that was short and sweet.
When the contender loses their weapon, they are automatically out of the competition.
On this bridge, Georgina certainly met her Waterloo. Another bad event for Georgie. She told us after her semi-final the importance of concentration in these events.
When I saw her fall off the beam, I also knew that, you know, this is my chance. Get off the ladder, straight onto the beam, and fly up the cargo net as fast as possible. But it, obviously, I couldn't think about her. I didn't really. I was aware that she'd fallen, but that was it. Nothing else occurred to me. I didn't even think about where she was or what she was doing, because all you can do is focus on yourself, and that's it. Once your attention goes elsewhere, that's when things go wrong for you. So, you know, I didn't think about it too much.
Well, she's got to find that focus now if she's to stand any chance against Jean in this grand final.
And up on her platform, waiting to do battle, is Jean! Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready! 3, 2, 1!
Well, Jean has yet to cross this bridge. Maybe this time she'll be lucky. On the other hand, maybe not. Nightshade just unbeatable on this bridge.
Jean, it was always going to be hard. Yet again, another height advantage she had. You took a pretty heavy knock the first one and a second one, I think.
Yeah, no, never mind.
What was going on through your mind when you first got off the platform?
Well, I was just trying to hold on to the stick because I've only got little hands and it's difficult to grip, so...
Well, the four times have you done it, have you actually got through at all over the other side?
No, I get knocked off every time.
OK, thanks very much, Jean.
After three events, Georgina's still on two, Jean on 17. It's over to the men's.
And up on his platform is Brian! And he's going to be facing the man who makes every contender his prey, the Hunter! Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! Three, two, one!
Well, Brian has a zero record in this event. Looks like his record remains unblemished. Thank you, Hunter.
Brian, is there a secret to the suspension bridge?
Yeah, don't climb up there.
Very few of our contenders actually reach the other side or knock any of the gladiators off. Why is it?
They're just so big, John, that's the thing. A lot of weight difference.
Is it about size, power?
Yeah, there's a bit of luck in there as well. He's a bit bigger than me, and I've been able to get past.
OK, off we go, Brian. And waiting to walk the suspension bridge is our martial arts expert, Phil!
And here's a man who's made it to the other side in his quarter-final.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! Three!
This should be interesting. Phil goes low and he goes high. And while Hunter's thinking about it, he goes by. Oh, he's dropped his hammerhead. Now, will that count? The ref seems to have let it go. A contentious issue.
Phil, tremendous. You better sit down and tell us about that. A little bit of the martial arts experts came in there.
Luck. I was going to try and take him off, take his legs. But I went to hit low and his leg just didn't move. I thought, hang on. And he started to come in towards me. I just got round him. So I just ran for it.
Is it possible to be able to actually knock him off?
I don't know about Hunter. It has been done before, but I don't know. You know, like the best thing in martial arts is to run. So that's what I did.
Well done. 10 points. Well done, Phil. And let's hear it for the Hunter.
So, after three events, Brian's on 7, Phil 22.
Mr. Anderson, I believe you've got something to tell us.
Yes, you will have noticed that the contender dropped his weapon in the course of making it to the other podium. However, he was at that point past the gladiator and had no further need of the weapon to protect himself and is therefore awarded the full 10 points.
Well, good decision from a good referee.
Now, John, we all know about all the contenders. We know all about the gladiators. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I've been coaching at Olympic level for many years, and I advise the British Olympic Association on fitness and conditioning.
People like names such as who?
Judy Simpson, David Moorcroft, David Bedford, Liz McColgan.
So you've seen the best of the best?
That's fair, yes. I've been to most Olympic Games.
So tell us, this is our second series now. Tell us, how fit are our gladiators, really?
I think they're very fit, and they match to the very best there is. What has to be remembered is that these athletes have taken many, many years to get to this level of fitness. They train for several hours every day. It doesn't happen in 5 minutes. Every one of the men that you see there has probably been training for at least 10 years, the women too. And on top of that, they have the very difficult problem of learning new skills for these events. They do it marvelously well, and on that basis, match the very best there is anywhere. And they are athletes of distinction.
Thank you very much, Mr. Anderson.
Thank you, John.
A fine tribute there from a man whose opinion you've got to respect.
Don't go away, because we're going to have a short break, and we'll be back and you can see the rest of the events on The Gladiators!
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena here in Birmingham. Well, with three events out of the way, we're going to bring our contenders just that little bit closer to the eliminator by kicking off event number four, which is swing shots. Getting ready to swing, it's Jean! Also 15 feet above the arena floor, it's Georgina! They're both going to be facing Zodiac! And Lightning! Over to John Anderson.
Three, two, one!
So, for the last time this season, Swing Out Sisters! And even though she's in the finals, this is Georgina's debut on Swing Shot, and Jean has only ever swung out once before. And this is the only event where you're encouraged to take a running jump. Here comes Georgina reaching up, pulls it yellow. On a second attempt, though. A yellow worth 1 point, two for a blue and three for a red. Zodiac for a block. She's got a yellow in the beak. She needs the points. Here comes lovely Jean Clank. And Georgie's got a two, a blue. Go Zodiac. Body checks her, but she hangs on to that yellow. And Georgina really getting the swing of this thing. 5 points, plays one. Well done, Georgina. Scores after four events, Georgina 7, Jean 18.
Getting ready to swing, it's Phil! Standing on his platform, it's Brian! They're both going to be swinging it out against Cobra! And Wolf!
Well, Brian's 15 points behind, but we've seen him come from behind before, and who could forget his heart-stopping semi-final?
The eliminator in the semi-final. There was one stage when it's going up on the first time on the Traveller, I thought, God, it's slipping away, I can't let it slip away, and that's when I decided to go back down and go for it again. And I went through and did it. It was great. Enjoyed it then. Put me close.
Three!
Who's the king of the swingers? The Gladiators VIP. You've got to reach for the top, then go for a drop, and we'll see how many points it'll be. Two for a blue there for Phil, and also for Brian. And a great block by Wolf, but he still steals the two. And Brian and Phil both come away with 2 points there. This time, it's 1 point, and doesn't Brian look like Captain Scarlet with that string attached? Here comes the Mr. Ons. Another 1 point for Brian. He's hungry. Outstretched. Fills up, and he misses. Oh, great block by the Cobra. And Wolf does a good job on Phil. Some great blocking by the Gladiators. Phil for a yellow. And there's Brian. He's going to be too late, though. Good work there by everybody. The boy's done good. Brian climbs to 13. Phil swings to 27. Next event, hang tough.
And the first of our female contenders getting ready to hang tough is Georgina! And she's going to be against Jets! Over to John Anderson.
Three, two,
swing time. And as we always say, hang tough, the ladies' least favourite event. And Georgina yet to score in it. She trains for 20 to 30 hours a week, everything from water sports to triathlons and aerobics, none of which require upper body strength, which this event, if you ask Jet, that's what it's all about. And she's in with the body scissors. And Georgina lucky there. Moving around the Jet. And Jet one rings. What's she doing? She thinks it's the Olympics. Well, she's lost momentum. She's trying to get it back, but that's not the way to do it. You don't want to do that, Jet. Oh, she's grabbed the leg. She's missed. And she goes down. And Georgina must get hold of a red win. She must. She's got seconds on the clock. She's not going to score. And look at the frustration in her face. She's lost momentum. She's so close, yet so far. In the replay, Jet tries to grab Georgina's foot, and Georgina kicks her into touch.
Oh, Georgina, you got to be cross with yourself, eh? You didn't get into the scoring zone. You don't get any points, I'm afraid. Did so well.
I just couldn't turn around. I just went away from it. Oh, God!
It looked like you were twisted up there.
Yeah, it's very hard to turn and get the momentum going to swing your body once you've turned the opposite way. Oh, well, keep going.
Good, done with those points. Never mind, Georgina.
No need to rub it in, John. Her face says it all.
And the second of our female contenders, ready to hang tough, is Jean!
Well, how does Jean rate her chances against Georgina?
Well, I've not watched Georgina in any of her games because it's clashed with times of mine, but I know Georgina's the youngest contender, me being the oldest contender. I'm hoping that having a bit more experience of life in general, I'll be able to keep calm and just plod along.
3, 2, 1!
It's swing time, and it's that old chestnut from what Jean says, age and experience against youth and enthusiasm. Gina, mum to little Joseph, a heavy goods lorry driver, and still finds time for hobbies like martial arts, boxing, running, weight training, motorbikes, and her ambition to meet and train with Mike Tyson. But oh my goodness, Jet locked in with the body scissors. Legs are up, but this time, look at this strength. Jean playing tremendous strength. The more you see Jean, the more you admire her. And she won't go. She won't budge. Jet finally presses the down button for a crash mat conclusion. Another one bites the dust. Cue those glad hands.
Oh, Jean. You were about, I think, a second off there. Second. Are you all right? What happened?
I hurt my elbow and my hand. And
was that when you fell or when she pulled you off?
When I fell.
Not too much damage, I hope.
Hope not. Never mind.
Could you have stayed up a little bit longer? You did so well.
I don't think so.
Well, well done. Jet.
Yeah. I've got to say, Jean was hanging tough, the name of the game. Very rarely done. Brilliant.
You had a struggle getting her off, didn't you? Oh. 1 second, I think, out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It was not the first.
Well, well done, both of you. Let's hear it for Jet and Jean.
After 5 events, no change in the scores. Georgina 7, Jean 18.
And the first of our men up is Brian! And I'm sure he's very happy that there's only one of them, a Saracen!
There's only one.
Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1!
Well, Brian has a good track record in this event. In the quarterfinal, he managed to hang tough for 5. And in his semi, if you remember, he picked up 10 after Wolf was disqualified. And he's going to need to pull out all the stops this evening because Sarah's no chump. He's coming in. Round the back. Doesn't wait for the invite. Come here, you. You're coming with me on the downtown train. And far from being a textbook takedown, Saracen shows his versatility by coming in on the blind side. Brian never stood a chance.
A little bit quicker than you hoped, I think, Brian.
Yeah, having a bit of a rough night, John, at the moment.
Well, let me tell you, Saracen has never come off the rings on his own. The only time he comes off is with a contender, so you've got a little bit of satisfaction there.
Yeah, that's right. Cheers, John.
Any ideas on what you were going to do, or did you just go for it?
I put my hand out, as you see, I missed the first ring I was going for and totally messed me up.
Could have done with those points, eh, Brian?
Could have done, yeah.
You'll need that when it comes to the Eliminator.
It's not over till the fat lady sings.
You're right. Off you go, Brian.
Who is this fat lady they keep talking about?
Up on the platform is Phil! Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
In the quarterfinal, Phil was one of the few to make it to the other side and pick up 10 points. And he put his martial arts to good use. He got himself a government enterprise scheme allowance to set up self-defense classes for women. Watch out, here comes Sarah. Oh, body scissors. Ba-boom! And another one bites the dust. Notch up another 2 for the Saracen.
Phil, I think we all saw what your plan was. You nearly got away with it.
Yeah, he's too quick. I thought that swing was going to take me past him, but he was just behind me.
One thing we have noticed about Saracen, when he actually starts, he seems to miss 2 or 3 hoops. Does it make a difference?
Oh yeah, he's in the middle before you're halfway across your own zone. They just get across real quick.
Could you make a decision on where you were going to go or anything, or is he only too quick?
Yeah, no, I was just going to take my time and just try and take it slowly and try and think, but he was on me straight away.
Saracen, tell us a secret. You've never come off. Tell us.
I was born up there, John. It's second nature to me. I mean, no one's going to get away.
Well done, Saracen. Let's hear it for Phil and Saracen. Saracen still undefeated.
Scores after 5 events. Brian stays on 13, Phil on 27. Event 6, duel.
First up on the women's duel, it's Georgina. And she's going to be facing Lightning. Over to John Anderson.
On guard. Three, two, one.
And Georgina perched precariously on the edge of that platform. She's got to be careful. She doesn't. Oh, she has. She stepped across. Instant disqualification. Nil point. A nice easy start for Lightning. While she struts her stuff, it's back to Uli.
Next up against Lightning, it's Jean. Over to John Anderson.
On guard. 3, 2, 1.
Well, both Jean Plank's previous bouts have been drawn, picking up 5 points each time. And no surprise, this lady has been the British Taekwondo champion for the last 3 years. A great defense, keeping Lightning at bay. And personally, I prefer less Plank, more Plonk. Oh! Tremendous work rate from Lightning, but it's all defensive work from Jean. And she's going to pull 5 points. Well played. And after 6 events, Georgina's on 7, Jean's 23. Now it's time for the event we've been waiting for all this season, the undefeated heavyweight champion of Duel. It's the big fella himself, Shadow. Well, if you saw last week's celebrity special, when he took on ex-British heavyweight champion Gary Mason, that ended in a draw. So what chance does Brian stand giving away 6 stone and 4 inches in height?
First up on the men's duel, it's Brian! And he's going to be facing the undefeated Shadow!
Three, two, one.
It's hammer time. time on a platform 12 feet in the air with nowhere to run. Shadow like a lumberjack chopping away at Brian with his pugil stick. And just like a mighty oak, Brian surely must be felled. Timber!
The man takes no prisoners.
Well, I think I had him worried there for a short while.
Yeah, very short while, like before he got up there.
Yeah.
Were you aware of his grunting?
No, he does do a lot of grunting, doesn't he? I wonder what he was doing actually when he was up there doing that.
Oh, well. Yeah. Well, he certainly beat you. Never mind. The Eliminator still to come. Brian!
Next up is Phil, and it must be like climbing the ladder to the guillotine platform. In his last bout, Phil took it to a draw and picked up 5 points. Before he started tonight's title campaign, I asked our martial arts instructor what condition he and Brian were in.
I've got to get through the games. We both have knee injuries, and I believe we're playing Powerball tonight. So that's the one that we've both been talking about that concerns us about a little bit. So if we can get through Powerball, you know, you have to cut our legs off, we'll still get up the Eliminator, we'll still get up the Travelator, we'll crawl up there, you know, we'll finish it, definitely. And it's good because his attitude's exactly the same, and he's really cool as well. Just needs to grow his hair.
Last time Phil met Shadow, it was a draw, and Shadow will want to put the record straight right now. This should be a good one.
One!
Shadow right on the whistle, doesn't waste time, and he's working to the head. Oh, he's changed direction, goes for the uppercut, completely confused. Phil, good night, Vienna. Can any man beat this gladiator at duel? Well, you'll have to wait until the next TV series, unless, of course, you join us at Wembley Arena for our live events on Easter Bank Holiday weekend.
Well, Phil, what can I say? You've really got to hand it to him.
Yeah, I didn't stand a chance up there then. Yeah, he had me straight away from the start.
Not looking forward to it at the beginning, were you?
I was ready for it, but he was just real quick on the whistle. He beat me on the whistle and then just finished it.
Well, we'll see you in a minute on the Eliminator. Let's hear it for Phil!
No change in the scores. Brian 13, Phil 27.
And once again, of course, we have eliminated our gladiators, but still to come is the Eliminator itself. So join us after the break here on Gladiators! Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena. Well, this is the final eliminator, the one that will decide our 1993 champions. But I'm afraid I'm going to have to keep you on the edge of your seats for just a moment as we listen to what John Sachs has to say.
Thanks, Ulrika. Jean leads Georgina by 16 points, so she has an 8-second head start, and Jean's got everything in her favour because Georgina has never really got to grips with this final.
Jean, you will start on my first whistle. Georgina, you will start on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
So it's age and experience and an 8-second advantage against youth and enthusiasm. This Eliminator course will take everything they can chuck at it and then some. Worth reminding ourselves that Gene only came into this competition as a replacement for the injured Tracy Johnson, who was concussed in a round of Powerball. And throughout this whole competition, Gene has been consistent, methodical, and professional. Up as Jean comes down the zip line. She's got to keep her head and her balance. Here comes Georgina, bad landing. And now, only a Travelator away from a cheque for £5,000 and a trip to Barbados. Yes, yes, there you have it. Jean Clegg Geronimo, Gladiator Champion 1993. And an angry three. Georgina and her boyfriend Simon knows it. She will be upset. Very upset. All that work and no focus. Oh, the bitter pill. And at 36, Jean Clank, the oldest female contender in the competition, who only got in by substitution. Who'd have thought this lorry-driving mum would win Gladiators 1993? And there, the two men in her life, there to share this emotional moment, husband Stuart and son Joseph. And there's mum Elsie and dad Ian.
Oh, Uga, congratulations. What do you think?
Fabulous.
Wasn't she fantastic?
Oh, can't believe it. Really proud of her. Anyway,
well,
mate.
Well, you said if you won, you were going to promise your little lad a trip.
To Disneyland, yeah. We'll take him there, definite.
What do you think? You're going to Disneyland?
Okay.
Nice, eh?
Brilliant. Thanks for all the support for everybody. It's wonderful.
Have you enjoyed it?
Very much, very much.
Let's hear for Jean!
Well, Georgina, I know you're painfully disappointed, but perhaps a cheque for £2,000 will help heal the wound.
I just want to say I've had a fantastic time. Gladiators are just wonderful, fit people, and just wish everyone well. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Georgina!
Jean, our champion, commiserates with Georgina there. And now it's time for the men to lock horns and give it all they've got. Phil leads Brian by 14 points, which gives him a 7-second head start. And both Phil and Brian have been down this cruel eliminator course three times before. They know what they've got to do.
Philip, you will start on my first whistle. Brian, you will start on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Well, this is it, the ultimate challenge. They're taking the high and low hurdles for the last time. And look at this boy go. Phil, the fastest across this eliminator, beat Dino in 54 seconds last time out. And look at him go. Brian knows he's got his work cut out. Look at the speed of this boy. Brian's wife, willing him on, and Phil whizzing up that cargo net. Girlfriend Lynn with the mum of Phil. Down the zip line. Surely, this one is all but over. Good balance. And Phil Norman strides up the final travel aid to the Gladiator glory. Song and Geronimo, £5,000, the champion of 1993. And here he comes, Brian, no shame for coming second when you think 9,000 entrants applied. Tremendous effort. And look at this, a gladiator cuddle from girlfriend Lynn and a very proud mum.
Brian, congratulations, you did come second.
Yeah, it's not bad, is it? I'll have to do it again now, though, won't I?
It's been absolutely great to see you. You've been smiling all the way through this. You've been a very positive person, great sportsman. That's what we like to see here on Gladiators.
Yep, I've really enjoyed myself. Thanks, everybody, for all your support and that. Thanks to my wife, mum, family, everybody. Thank you.
Oh, which reminds me, it was something you said before you did the Eliminator about giving all the money to your wife.
Yeah!
Is that right?
Come and get it.
That's a great promise. Let's hear it for Brian.
Well, mum, what do you think about that?
Absolutely brilliant. Thank you, everyone.
And what do you think, Phil's young lady?
Well, we just knew he could do it.
£5,000 richer. Trip to Hollywood. American Gladiators. What do you got to say for yourself, Phil? You worked hard for it.
Yeah, okay. All the time since I've been up here, I've always been thinking of what I was going to say if I lost. And every show, I had this speech for if I lost on that show. And I'm glad I haven't had to use it.
Well, congratulations. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
You can have that one. Here you go.
Michelle grabs the money. Mum gets the trophy, but Brian keeps the memories. Talking of which, let's take a look back at some of the highlights of this season's Gladiators.
To our champions, Phil and Gene. But thanks very much for watching. We're going to be back again next year when you can see some more great events on the Gladiators.
Good night. Bye. Bye.
Books, food, Britain, I get. Affairs, now there's a dubious category if ever I saw one. Bullseye is next on Challenge, and tonight at 9, four contestants are focused on getting home. No, not because it's past their bedtime. Home to the rest of their team with cash, hopefully, in the chase.
Attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators. Both contenders and gladiators have been trained for this competition, and safety equipment is mandatory.